Hello students, welcome back to our last session of science chapter 2 components of food. So till now we have studied all the components of food in detail. Now we are going to conclude the chapter by the two very important concepts, balanced diet and deficiency diseases. Today we will learn the importance of having balanced diet in our routine life. Okay, let's begin.
Class 6, Science, Chapter 2, Components of Food. We need energy for various external as well as internal activities. We also need nutrients for the growth and development of our body. All these are obtained from food. The food we normally eat in a day is our diet. For growth and maintenance of good health, our diet should have all the nutrients that our body needs in right quantities. For example, nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals should be present in food in right quantities. Not too much of one and not too little of the other. The diet should also contain a good amount of roughage and water. Such a diet is called a balanced diet. We can say a diet which contains a good balance of all the nutrients is called a balanced diet. Basically, a single food item is not sufficient to provide all the nutrients. In order to have all the nutrients, we have to take a mixture of food items, each of which is rich in and sufficient for a particular nutrient. So, now you understood why your meal consists of so much of variety? So that our body can get all the essential nutrients. Do you think that people of all ages need the same type of diet? No, balanced diet changes with our age. Because with the age, there are changes in our body as well as our activities. The diet must be supportive to these changes. And so, one must consume appropriate diet. That is, balanced diet required at that age. Balanced diet also depends on the amount of physical work we do. That means, nutritional needs is different for each person. Therefore, balanced diet is different for different person. Even at the same age, different people may not have same diet. For example, a boy's diet at a particular age is different than the girl's diet. In fact, balanced diet varies from season to season and place to place. For example, a balanced diet of a person living in a village is different from the balanced diet of a person living in a city. For balanced diet, it is not necessary to have expensive food materials. In fact, simple meals can also serve the purpose. For example, mixture of cereals, mixture of jawar and ragi, or rice with bajra, some sprouted seeds. We may have plenty of green vegetables, different fruits like apple, banana, guava, fermented food like idli. All these are cost-effective balanced diet, which is good for health. Common cooking mistakes. We should also make sure that the food is cooked correctly. For example, cutting the vegetables or fruits and then washing them may lead to removal of essential nutrients. Repeated washing of rice or pulses can also cause removal of some nutrients. If excess water is used during cooking, then also some nutrients get removed from food. Now we will talk about junk food. Junk food often contains large amount of fats and no or very little amount of nutrients. In unhygienic conditions, it may also contain some disease-causing agents. So, do you think eating junk food is a right choice? No, it is not. In fact, it often causes many health problems, such as obesity. Obesity is a disorder which is caused because of excessive intake of fats in the diet, which increases the risk of health problems. Malnutrition. Improper nutrition results in malnutrition. If a particular nutrient is very less or not available for longer time, then it leads to undernutrition or undernourishment. Likewise, getting too much of nutrients causes overnutrition or also known as overnourishment. Both undernutrition and overnutrition are malnutrition, because overnutrition causes abnormal development of body parts and undernutrition may cause stunted growth and many similar problems. So, having a balanced diet is very important. Deficiency diseases. A person may be getting enough food to eat, but sometimes a certain nutrient is missing from the diet. If this continues over a long period of time, the person may suffer from its deficiency. Deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause diseases or disorders in our body. Diseases that occur due to lack of nutrients over a long period are called deficiency diseases. Let's have a look on some of the common deficiency diseases. Protein deficiency. As we know, proteins are the very important components of the food. Protein helps in building up our body. If the diet is deficient in protein, then it may lead to stunted growth, discoloration of hair, skin diseases, swelling of the face, and diarrhea. Such person should include protein-rich food in their diet. Good sources of protein are milk, eggs, paneer, mung dal, beans, and gram. Protein and carbohydrate deficiency. If the diet is deficient in protein as well as carbohydrate over a long time, then there is a threat of stopping the growth completely. The person in such case is lean and thin, and then he becomes so weak that it is even difficult for him to move. The person must intake foods such as rice, bajra, wheat, mango, sugarcane, potato. They are the good sources of carbohydrate. Vitamins and minerals deficiency. Deficiency of vitamin A causes loss of vision. It causes poor vision in human beings, loss of vision in darkness, that is night blindness, which may lead to complete blindness. Such person should intake foods such as carrots, spinach, cheese, milk, sweet potatoes in their diet. They are the good sources of vitamin A. Deficiency of vitamin B1 causes beriberi. It is a disease which causes weak muscles and very little energy to do work. Some sources of vitamin B1 are nuts, oats, oranges, corn, sunflower seeds, etc. Deficiency of vitamin C causes scurvy, a disease which causes bleeding in gums. Inability of body to heal the wounds which causes loss of blood and other diseases. The person should include vitamin C rich food in the diet. Good sources of vitamin C are kiwi, oranges, green leafy vegetables, potatoes and bell peppers. Deficiency of vitamin D causes poor absorption of calcium and so the bones become soft and weak. The disease is called rickets. The person should intake food which are rich in vitamin D. Cheese, eggs, fatty fish, mushrooms, milk. They are some of the good sources of vitamin D. Mineral deficiency. Calcium. Calcium is important for strong teeth and bone. If there is deficiency of calcium in a diet, then it may lead to weak bones and tooth decay. The person should consume food rich in calcium. Good sources include yogurt, almond, cheese, beans, lentils, and milk. Deficiency of iron causes lack of hemoglobin in the blood, which reduces the oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, which causes fatigue and weakness in the body, which lead to a deficiency disease called anemia. Beans, lentils, cashews, potatoes, whole grain bread, green leafy vegetables, they are some of the good sources of iron. Deficiency of iodine causes a deficiency disease called goiter, in which thyroid gland present in the neck swells abnormally. Deficiency of iodine leads to poor growth and poor development of body, which leads to mental disability in children. The person should include food rich in iodine. Dairy products like milk, yogurt, cheese, and iodized salt. They are some of the good sources of iodine.
So, here we have completed our chapter 2 components of food. So now we all are aware about the sources and functions of nutrients present in the food. We have also gained knowledge on balanced diet and deficiency diseases. So now I request you all to read and revise the chapter properly and prepare yourself for solving worksheets. Okay, so all the very best. Take care and thank you.